Welcome to Gospel Truth with Andrew Womack, a teaching ministry that focuses on God's unconditional love and grace.
I love the straightforwardness and the simplicity that he uses to teach.
His teachings are very simple for everybody to understand.
If it hadn't been for this ministry, I don't know where I would be.
And now, here's Andrew.
Welcome to our Wednesday's broadcast of the Gospel Truth. This is a very special series of programs that I'm making. The Lord really laid it on my heart to just emphasize how absolutely essential a daily understanding of the Word of God is. And so I am calling this the Year of the Bible. I'm asking you to join with me. I've got this little brochure here that has every day of the year printed and a Bible reading that goes with it so that you could actually read through the entire Bible in 1 year. And so we're giving this away as a gift. We've also got a PDF, I believe it is, of this on my website that you can go and get. And one of the things we're doing, we've got a special place on our website where you could go and sign up to read through the Bible in 1 year. You know, it says in Timothy, it says, God is faithful and just to keep that which I've committed unto Him. No committing, no keeping. And most people have a desire. They know they should be in the Word, but they haven't committed to doing it. And so we've got a place there where you could sign up and make a commitment to read through the Bible in 1 year. It's not the kind of commitment that something terrible is going to happen to you if you don't do it, but you need to commit. It needs to be more than just a thought or a desire. And so we're doing that, but then I'm also offering this teaching on effortless change, which is a classic teaching that I've had out for, I don't know, decades, over a decade. And this has changed hundreds of thousands of people's lives. And then I've got a brand new teaching that I'm calling Plain as Dirt. And you know, this really comes from this teaching right here. I'm in the midst of this teaching. We're going to get into this today. But I had a man come to me at one of my meetings, I think it was in Kansas City, and he came up and he says, you know, you are as plain as dirt. And he went on to say that how God had used me in spite of my plainness. But I'm sure he didn't mean that as a great compliment. But you know what? If you understand what the Scripture is teaching, plain as dirt is awesome. Here's another way of saying it. Have you ever thought of this, that everything that you see above ground was at one time in the ground? And I know most people had never thought of that. But think about it. Did you know iron is just minerals, rocks taken out, melted and combined and put together, steel, all of these kind of things. All of the stuff that's in your electronics, any of those electronics, the glass was sand, you know, that has been melted and turned into glass, and on you could go. Trees, everything that came out of the ground was at one time in the ground. That is a miraculous statement. I'm going to develop this and be saying this, but this is something that God has shown me recently that has really just emphasized to me how miraculous dirt is. Look at this again. I was in this parable yesterday in Mark chapter 4 in verse 26. It says, so is the kingdom of God as if a man should cast seed into the ground and should sleep and rise night and day, and the seed should spring and grow up. He knoweth not how. Now we talked about that on our program yesterday. And then in verse 28, it says, for the earth bringeth forth fruit of herself. First the blade, then the ear, after that the full corn in the ear. But when the fruit is brought forth, immediately he putteth in the sickle, because the harvest is come. But notice in this verse 28, it says, for the earth bringeth forth fruit of herself. You know, I heard a man one time take an apple seed, and he held up an apple seed like this, and he says, anybody can count the number of seeds in an apple, but no one can count the number of apples in a seed. And he was making the point that you plant this seed and out of it comes an apple tree, and then all of these apples that have trees, and then they produce, and it just goes on and on. There could be millions and millions and millions, billions of apples in that one seed. Did you know, I understand the point that's being made about the potential and stuff, but according to this verse, notice it says in verse 28, for the earth bringeth forth fruit of herself. Did you know that the apple seed does not have apples in it? An acorn does not have oak trees in it. What that seed does, the seed somehow activates the ground. It says, the earth bringeth forth fruit of herself. The earth is what's miraculous. Now, the seed is the catalyst. I'm not saying that the seed is unimportant. It is absolutely necessary. But the seed activates the ground, and the earth brings forth fruit of herself. Go back again to that statement I made, that everything that we see above the ground was at one time in the ground. Did you know that that's even true of your and my bodies? It says in Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, that the Lord created man from the dust of the ground, and then He breathed into him the breath of life. It's this spirit, the breath of life, that is actually who we are. That's our true self. We are a spiritual being, but we indwell a physical body, and this physical body at one time was dirt. You know, I thought about calling this series, "You're a Dirt Bag," but most people thought that that wouldn't be really encouraging, that a lot of people might not get the series. But if you understand what I'm talking about, dirt is miraculous. Let me turn over and read some things to you out of the first chapter of the book of Genesis. If you can get hold of this, this will really help you. This is an added revelation that the Lord gave me from this teaching that I've gotten titled Effortless Change. But here in Genesis chapter 1 and in verse 11, it says, "And God said, let the earth bring forth grass." Notice, let the earth bring forth grass, the herb yielding seed and the fruit tree yielding fruit after his kind, whose seed is in itself upon the earth. And it was so. And the earth brought forth grass and herb yielding seed after his kind, and the tree yielding fruit whose seed was in itself after his kind. And God saw that it was good. And the evening and the morning were the third day. But notice, God said, let the earth bring forth. Man, I've got a greater revelation of this than what I've got the ability to say it right now. I feel like, man, I'm just not doing justice to this. But if you could understand that in the ground, when God created the ground, you know, in the previous day it says, let the dry land appear. And when God brought this ground together, in the ground was grass and trees and fruit and all of these things. It was already in the ground, and His Word became a seed. Again, over in 1 Peter chapter 1, verse 23, it says, being born again, not of corruptible seed, but of incorruptible seed by the Word of God that lives and abides forever. You know, if you saw some of my teaching during the month of December, I was teaching on this concerning the virgin birth, how that the Word of God is a seed. And in the original Greek language, the word seed there is spora. That's where we get a spore from, how a flower is pollinated and reproduces. And spora is a derivative, or it's akin to the word sperma, where we get the word sperm from. And so in the same way that a man releases sperm and plants it in a woman's womb, that's how a person comes into being. Well, in the same way, the Word of God is a seed, a sperm, and God spoke to the ground. God put His Word in the ground. And remember over there in Mark chapter 4, verse 28, it says, for the earth bringeth forth fruit of herself. Notice the feminine there. It calls the ground herself. The ground is feminine, and the Word of God is the sperm, the seed. And so God spoke, and out of the ground, that's what it says in verse 12, and the earth brought forth grass. Now God's Word became the seed, the sperm, and He spoke to the ground. Everything that came out of the ground was at one time in the ground. God created all of these things. You know, I don't know how God did this, but there's many scriptures over in the book of Proverbs that the worlds were created by the wisdom of God, and that the wisdom of God did all of these things. I don't believe God just said, let there be, you know, creation. Let there be trees. Let there be grass. No, he thought all of this stuff out. Now, because he's God, he might have thought it out really quickly. But nonetheless, he thought it out in detail. And when he created dirt, in that dirt was grass and trees and fruit trees and everything that we see above the ground. He thought out about rocks, and he knew that rocks had the potential to be able to melt it down and turn it into steel and iron and, you know, all of the elements, all of the copper that we use for our wiring. These things, man didn't come up with this. Man didn't invent anything. They didn't create anything. All they've done is just take what God did and they've learned how to use it. But God thought through all of this. God thought through electricity, how electrons flow through certain things like copper better than they do through wood. God thought all of this stuff out. And we are just discovering what God has already planned. Everything in His wisdom, He put in dirt everything that this world will ever need. You know, we're talking about all of the fossil fuels and how it's polluting the atmosphere and stuff, and I don't agree with a bit of that. And I'm not going to sit here and spend a lot of time on this, but that mindset is that they just believe, see, that things just happened, that the earth is fragile, that we can deplete it and do all these kind of things. God thought through everything. And if the population of the world ever gets to where it's 20 billion people or whatever it is, God knew exactly what was coming, and He made this earth to be able to sustain anything that we ever need. We've got, I read an email, and somebody sent me this thing, and they have discovered an oil reserve. I believe it's in either North or South Dakota, that they say that the oil reserves there are greater than all of the Arab nations all put together, that the United States has enough oil reserves in shale oil and in just regular oil and stuff that they could run the world as it is for over 200 years. There is no shortage of this the way that some people are thinking that there is. Some people think, but it's polluting the atmosphere, and I'm not saying that we should just ignore things and destroy the place that we live in. I went out to Los Angeles in the 70s, and I mean, when you were driving on their freeways, you couldn't see a bridge until you got right under it because the pollution was so bad. I think that's terrible. And yes, we need to clean things up. But you know, there's no shortage of anything. There may be a shortage of us understanding, but I've actually known a person who has built an engine that runs off of water. It separates the hydrogen and the oxygen from the out of the water, and it burns that hydrogen, and they actually have run that. I don't know that that's perfected so that we can use it, but there's things like that. There are ways that we can do things. Whatever the needs are, God put it all in the dirt. Anything that we will ever need is already here. And if you continue reading down here in Genesis chapter 1, it says in verse 20, it says, "And God said, let the waters bring forth abundantly the moving creature that hath life, and the fowl that may fly above the earth in the open firmament of the heaven. And God created great whales and every living creature that moveth, which the waters brought forth abundantly." Again, God didn't create them somewhere else. He brought them out of the waters, all of the flying fowl and all of the fishes. And then in verse 24, it says, "And God said, let the earth bring forth the living creature after his kind, cattle and creeping thing and beast of the earth after his kind. And it was so." Notice it says, God said, let the earth bring forth. God didn't create the animals in some way outside of things. They were already in the earth. Again, I just feel like it's hard for me to express this the way that God has shown it to me. But in that dirt was elephants and dogs and cats and bugs and everything. God created it in the dirt. Dirt is miraculous. So this man that called me a dirt bag, he may not have known it, but man, he was just, he was saying something miraculous. Ground is absolutely supernatural. And when you plant a seed, that seed does not actually produce a tree and fruit. That seed activates the miraculous power that God put in dirt, and the earth brings forth fruit of herself. And you know, if you go back over to Mark chapter 4, the parable that we're using here, that phrase, of herself, is actually the Greek word automatos. And it's a word that we get automatic and automatically from. This is saying that the ground brings forth fruit automatically of herself. The seed is just the catalyst. It's what makes everything begin to work. But the ground is what's miraculous. And the comparison of this in this parable is the ground is our heart. Did you know when you got born again, you were created in righteousness and true holiness, Ephesians 4:24. 1 John chapter 4, verse 17 says, as Jesus is, so are you in this world. Not going to be in the world to come, but in this world. That's not talking about your physical body, because your body's got to change. It's not talking about your mental, emotional part, that part of you. You only know in part and you prophesy in part. But in your spirit, you are identical to Jesus. 1 Corinthians 6:17 says, he that is joined unto the Lord is one spirit. And that Greek word for one is hes, H-E-I-S, and it means a singular one to the exclusion of another. We aren't one in the sense that we're similar. It's not like God's here and here we are down here. No, we are identical. In the spirit realm, if there are things like atoms and molecules, you are atom for atom, molecule for molecule, identical to Jesus. You have the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwelling in you. Ephesians chapter 1, verse 19. And if anybody says, well, I don't think that's me. Well, Romans chapter 8, verse 9 says, if any man have not the spirit of Christ, he is none of his. If you are truly born again, God came and lived on the inside of you. Your ground in the spirit realm is miraculous. It's got everything that you will ever need. But just as God had to speak and His Word was a seed, a sperm, and that seed was planted in the ground, and out of the ground came forth animals and came forth grass and trees. It was already in the ground, but His seed activated that ground and it began to start spring and grow up. Did you know in the same way, God's Word is a seed. And when you take that seed and plant it in your heart, the combination of God's supernatural seed, sperm, the Word of God, it touches your heart. And in your heart, you're already identical to Jesus, and it starts drawing out of you everything that God has placed on the inside of you. Man, if you understand, if you got what I'm saying, this is a game changer. If this is true, which it is, then why in the world aren't we putting God's Word in our heart and embracing it and letting it stay there and let the seed bring forth, activate the ground, and then this ground, this supernatural ability that's in our born-again spirit will just bring forth fruit of herself. It will work automatically. It's impossible for you to meditate in the Word of God day and night and not be prosperous and not have good success. Joshua chapter 1, verse 8. It's impossible for you to meditate in the Word of God day and night and not be like a tree that's planted by the rivers of water that lasts through any drought, through any hard time that you go through. You know, I minister to a lot of people and I travel and I see people. And I see some people who at one time just love God, they're excited about God, but over a period of time they fall away and they quit coming to the meetings, they get into terrible things. And I can guarantee there's probably multiple things involved, but I can promise you this, that they were not established in the Word of God. They may have been touched by the Lord. They may have emotionally embraced the Lord and desired the things of God, but they weren't established in it. You know, I've been meditating in the Word of God for 53 years, night and day. And I mean, it has been my delight. And I've been focused on the Word of God. And I've been through some hard things. I'm not going to sit here and glorify the devil and tell you about all of them, but I've been through a lot of things that I've seen other people quit over those things that have happened to them. And yet, I just can't because the Word of God. I mean, I guess I could if I was to, you know, start pulling up all of the things that God has planted in my heart. I guess He doesn't force me, but because I've been meditating in the Word of God, I honestly, it's just, I can't quit. The Word of God has transformed my thinking so much. I had a doctor one time tell me I had a serious heart problem. He was going to put me in the hospital and probably do open heart surgery on me before the day was over. And I just couldn't embrace that. I said, that's a lie. And I just refused it. And of course, it turned out nothing's wrong with my heart and stuff. But I'm saying that many people would just crumble in a situation like that because they take the word of a doctor more than they take the word of God. Man, I have gotten to where I've taken God's word and it's working in my life, and I'm trying to encourage you that this is the greatest thing that you can do for your spiritual growth, your relationship with the Lord, and your ability to receive everything that God has provided for you. You got to take the seed and plant it in your heart. And then what's miraculous, your born-again spirit, it will just automatically, of herself, begin to start bringing forth the things that you need. And if that's true, which it is, then man, we need to be taking the Word of God and putting it in our heart more than we ever have before. I know that some of you watching this program, you have done that. And you would just shout and testify, yes, it works, because you've seen the miraculous happen just through you meditating in the Word of God. But then there's many people who are listening to this that intellectually you might say, well, yes, that's true. But then practically you aren't doing anything about it. This is the reason that I'm really trying to encourage you to let's read through the Bible in 1 year. That's not an end in itself, but it is a beginning place. You need to do this the rest of your life. But for this year, I would like to encourage you to just join with me and make a commitment to read through the Bible in 1 year. I've got this little Bible reading plan here. You can go to our website and you can also download this as a PDF. And we've got a place there where you can sign up and make a commitment. Now that we've got our garage paid off, I'm going full steam ahead on building student housing. We're breaking ground in the spring, and we are believing that by the fall of 2023, we are going to have student housing. It just depends on how the response goes as to how quickly we can build it. And so I'd like to encourage you to pray about becoming a foundation builder with us. That's what we call this partnership for building out our Charis Bible College. Check it out at awmi.net. Whatever His dream for you is, everything that it takes to accomplish that is already provided. It's already been given in the spirit realm.
True courage is the ability to do what's necessary and do what's right, even when we have fear.
What is a dead end to us? Is nothing but an opportunity for God to show forth who He is.
Andrew has declared that 2022 is the year of the Bible. Commit to reading through the Bible in a year by going to awmi.net/Bible Pledge. Andrew is offering his Bible reading plan free of charge when you go to our website. Visit awmi.net and select Bible Reading Plan under the Read tab. Andrew's complete teaching, Plain as Dirt, is available in a CD or DVD album for a gift of any amount. This teaching is also available as a DVD recorded live at a ministry event. Also today, Andrew is offering his entire teaching, Effortless Change. This series is available in a book, study guide, and in a CD or DVD album. Each of these valuable resources is available for a gift of any amount. Both series are also available for audio download absolutely free from our website. Go to awmi.net to see all the ways you can get these teachings.
This revelation has been too much in our lives for us not to give back and not to partner, not want to be a part of what he's continuing to do throughout the entire world.
Andrew Womack is spreading the word of God worldwide, and I'm thankful to be a part of this ministry.
You can become a Grace Partner through our website at awmi.net. While there, you can discover more product details and download additional free resources. You can also order resources or receive prayer by calling our helpline at 719-635-1111. Our helpline is open 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. We appreciate your generosity and hope to hear from you today.
If you are born again, I'm telling you who you are in your spirit. And if you could get beyond what you have done and your mistakes and all the things you're doing, and if you would see who you are in Christ, it would wind up being reflected in your life. You would change more accidentally than you ever have changed on purpose before trying to make yourself change. Just start rejoicing in the fact that you're forgiven and that God loves you, and I guarantee you, it'll go to changing your behavior. You were created in righteousness and true holiness. That is now your nature. If you were left to nothing but your new nature, if you could somehow or another been born again when you were born physically, and if you never grew up in a fallen world, and if you never were taught the wrong stuff and never all of that, you would just naturally live a holy life because that's who you are at your core.
You have the opportunity to attend Charis and be immersed in the full Charis experience. Andrew would like to offer you the online version of the complete 8-lesson course free of charge. That's a $120 catalog value, absolutely free. Each person who completes this course will receive Charis credit hours, so you can get started with Charis today. This is a limited time, web-only offer. Visit our website to start your free online course today.
Charis Bible College will help you discover who you are in Christ and lead you to a deeper understanding of your God-given calling and purpose.
There are some of you here wondering about, should I do this? If you have a desire to be here, it's because God put that desire in your heart.
To learn more about Charis Bible College, come to Campus Days. Meet Charis instructors and sit under the Word of God. Join us for Campus Days, April 6th through the 8th in Woodland Park, Colorado.
I've got some great news to share with you, and that is that we have now expanded our phone center hours to 24/7. Anytime you want to call us, we're going to be open to receive your calls. We've been expanding gradually, and this is a goal that I've been shooting at, and I'm excited because, you know, sometimes problems, needs don't just wait until business hours to happen. You may need to call in the middle of the night, and we can now serve you 24/7 on our Andrew Womack Ministries helpline.
Did you know Andrew Womack Ministries is on Facebook, Twitter, YouTube, Instagram, and Pinterest? We pray that we can bless you with the Word of God wherever you are in the world on any of these platforms.